Hey guys, it's billyrood from 58 magazine.
I just have a couple of questions.
Mr. Gray will see you now.
What was he like?
He was polite, intense, smart, really intimidating.
In this video, we'll be about the 50 Shades trilogy. Do you think 50 Shades of Grey is just about sex? Think again. Beneath the passion lies a deeper story. But in order to see it, you'll need to confront the ego's grip on control and desire. And this is probably one of my steamiest videos. But let's be real. But the symbolism in these films is like a masterclass in understanding your own ego. Esoteric symbolism in film and TV uses three-dimensional characters to symbolize unseen aspects of the human psyche and the journey to remembering who you truly are. Films are never literal, and the main character and their relationships they have represent aspects of their consciousness pushed out into three-dimensional reality. And in 50 Shades of Grey, the main character, Anastasia Steele, experiences the journey of awakening to the seduction, control, limitations, and darkness of her own ego mind in Christian Grey.
Oh my God.
Are you ready to see the hidden esoteric truths and unveil the dominating control of the ego mind? So let's begin.
You're here because I'm incapable of leaving you alone.
Then don't.
I don't do romance. My tastes are very singular. You wouldn't understand.
Enlighten me then.
Welcome to my world.
And the 50 Shades of Grey films explore an esoteric journey from lust to true love. The trilogy is a story of seduction, control, and ultimately transformation. And beneath the surface of a steamy romance and lust, it explores a profound esoteric journey, how the mind's need for control and the ego's lustful cravings poison relationships and block the path to true love. And for women, Anastasia Steele's journey reveals how confronting the ego's illusions of love leads to peace, fulfillment, and the heart's liberation. It is the spiritual journey into loving her own ego mind from control to freedom, the love of self. And to really understand the ego mind, this opening scene in their dialogue speaks to the personality of the ego mind.
I've always found that the harder I work, the more luck I seem to have. The key to my success has been in identifying talented individuals and harnessing their efforts.
So you're a control freak?
Oh, I exercise control in all things, Miss Steele.
Anastasia interviews him, which is symbolic of how the heart tries to understand the ego and its lack of love.
I just wonder if perhaps your heart might be a bit bigger than you want to let on.
There's some people who say that I don't have a heart at all.
Why would they say that?
Because they know me well.
This polarity of the heart and mind out of balance creates tension and desire.
Earlier you said that there are some people who know you well. Why do I get the feeling that that is not true?
This desire, often confused with love, is what is known as lust.
Look at me.
I am.
The control of the mind's desire over the love of the heart. And the explanation of Anna's family reveals her own disharmony with her father representing her heart and her mother, her mind.
My dad died when I was a baby, so I was raised by my stepfather, Ray. He's amazing.
And your mother?
My mother is on husband number 4. She's an incurable romantic.
You?
Am I a romantic? Well, I study English lit, so I kind of have to be.
And this tension between her ego and her heart is the dance of yin and yang inside all of us. When her heart isn't full, the ego tries to control her with his own insecurity.
I find you intimidating.
You should. Eat.
Not to mention high-handed.
I'm used to getting my own way.
That must get very boring.
I'm not the man for you. You should steer clear of me. I have to let you go.
This is how we all get seduced by the ego mind, with all its intrusive thoughts of control, aggression, power, and excess.
If you were mine, you wouldn't be able to sit down for a week.
What?
In the first film, Christian Grey draws Anastasia into his intense world of passion and control, initiating her into a relationship bound by a contract.
What's this?
It's a non-disclosure agreement. It means that you cannot discuss anything about us with anyone.
Are you gonna make love to me now?
Two things. First, I don't make love. I fuck hard.
And the second thing?
Come.
Christian's attraction to physical dominance and explicit terms mask his inability to connect on an emotional level, symbolizing how the ego craves control, attachment, and satisfaction through lust rather than love. And when Anastasia is introduced to the playroom, she is realizing the visual representation of the control of her own mind in its desire of pain as pleasure. She soon realizes that the ego mind only wants control of the heart rather than connection. And the ego, which is always symbolized in films as me, Anna's questioning of her own mind is symbolizing introspection and seeing beyond the limits of the mind and its limited programming.
You're a sadist?
I'm a dominant.
What does that mean?
It means I want you to willingly surrender yourself to me.
Why would I do that?
To please me.
To please you? How?
I have rules. If you follow them, I'll reward you. If you don't, I'll punish you.
You'd punish me? Like you'd use this stuff on me?
Yes.
What would I get out of this?
And for Anastasia, these early encounters are captivating, yet troubling. She finds herself enticed by the thrill, yet hesitant about its true meaning. She starts to realizing the dominating behavior and control of her own mind in Christian Grey.
What if I don't want anything to do with that?
I would understand completely.
But then we wouldn't have any sort of relationship at all?
This is the only sort of relationship I have.
Why?
It's the way I am.
Christian's need to control even the sexual aspects of their relationship represents the ego's toxic tendencies.
When you said negotiate, what did you mean?
I already have a contract prepared. It's fairly detailed. You would review it, and we would negotiate what you are and are not willing to try.
How could I know what I'd be willing to try?
Well, when you've had sex, was there anything that you didn't like doing? We have to be honest with each other for this to work, okay? I would like to fuck you into the middle of next week.
You're not fighting fair.
I never have.
I'll review all these changes and try to arrive at a decision.
You want to leave?
Yes.
It mistakes desire for love, thinking that intensity alone can bring fulfillment. Lust poisons their connection, leading to feelings of emptiness and doubt for Anastasia, who senses that something is missing.
What's the matter? Nothing, I'm fine.
Is he not making you happy?
He is, yeah. And most of the time, yeah. It's complicated.
Something more profound than just physical intimacy. She realizes the pain of her own mind.
I told you before, if you want out.
I don't want out. I'm not exactly jumping at the opportunity to get whipped and tortured in your red room of pain.
That room is much more about pleasure. I promise you.
This surrendering of the heart and self to the ego and its comfort zone of control and dominance is the main issue with humanity and its lack of awareness.
If you agree to be my submissive, I will be devoted to you. This is what I want. I want it with you.
Why do I have to sleep in here? We slept in the same bed last night, like normal people.
Try not to get hung up in the sleeping arrangements. If you agree to do this, you're gonna want your own room.
Why? Because I'll be your sex slave?
I don't want to do this here. Let's talk downstairs.
No, you know what? I think I'll hold on to my free will a little while longer. Thank you.
To really understand the ego is to understand the abandonment and lack of love that creates the desire for pleasure and control to hide the pain.
Did that hurt?
No.
You see? Less of your fears in your head.
I need more. I want more.
Hearts and flowers? That's not something I know. Anna, please. It's you that's changing me.
Let me touch you. Let me.
Spiritually, pain is the same as pleasure. There is no separation, and the abandonment is symbolized as Christian's childhood and not remembering his mother, which is symbolic of his heart.
The woman that gave birth to me was a crack addict and a prostitute. She died when I was 4. I remember certain things. Terrible things. I don't remember her.
And at the end of the first film, Anna requests to see how bad her mind can punish her for its pleasure, symbolizing the pain the mind creates when we go unconscious and submissive to the ego mind's control.
Why do you want to punish me?
Anna.
Why do you want to hurt me?
I would never do anything to you that you couldn't handle.
But why do you even want to do anything to me at all, Christian?
If I told you, you'd never look at me the same way again.
So there is a reason. Tell me. Do you want to punish me right now?
Yes. I want to punish you right now.
What if I told you that I feel the same way about being punished as you do about me touching you? Would you still want to punish me then?
No. But that doesn't mean I wouldn't need to.
Why?
Anna, stop.
Why do you need to?
Because it's the way I am! Because I'm 50 shades of fucked up.
Show me then. I need you to show me what you want to do to me. Punish me. Show me how bad it can be. I want you to show me the worst. It's the only way I can understand.
When the mind loses its control and is faced to become authentic and accountable for its actions, it acts irrationally and creates walls to close it from the heart.
This is giving you pleasure. Don't. Don't you dare come near me.
Anna, becoming aware of the darkness of the mind, finally takes back her power and confronts Christian and becoming the dominant force of her own mind.
Stop. No!
Anna.
The second film of the trilogy shows the trauma and pain of the ego mind's abandonment from the heart, which is symbolized in this non-existent drug-addicted mother.
My birth mother died when I was 4. She was an addict. Crack. You can fill in the blanks.
The drug addiction also symbolizes the addiction to the lower states of consciousness, which is the world of the ego mind. When they see each other again, it's Anna becoming aware that there is no separation from pain and pleasure.
I'd like to renegotiate terms.
But I don't see how. The things you want, you said that's the way you are.
But what happened last time, it's not gonna happen again.
You were getting off on the pain you inflicted. That's still in you.
I'm working on it.
The mind is always in torment and living in the past, hiding the pain while the heart is always open and understanding within reason without rules, punishments, and control. Full transparency. And this is how the heart transforms the mind from lust to love. The ego mind seeks materialism and control over its reality instead of acceptance.
You're mine.
Yours.
And this scene shows when the heart begins to take control of the mind, which is the path of fulfilling your destiny.
No rules, no punishments, and no more secrets.
I can do that.
And the heart always seeks truth and transparency, no matter how difficult it might be for the ego to admit.
It's all wrong. All of this is wrong. You put money into my account that I don't want it. You bought the company I work for. This isn't a relationship, Christian. It's ownership.
I'm trying to understand you. I am just wanting to get close to you. But it's really difficult to do that when you keep doing bizarre things like this. And it's really difficult to do that when you won't let me touch you.
The ego seeks to control and dominate life when all the heart wants to do is connect. This is symbolized in Christian showing that his boundaries lay outside the heart.
Start here. Those are my boundaries.
I can live with that.
Then I'm all yours.
And being vulnerable and honest is always the path to freedom from the pain of the mind. The spiritual journey is about understanding this darkness, the unconscious of the ego mind and all its past lower states of being. This type of control is when we are unconscious is the reason behind all the suffering in the world, which is symbolized in this character, Leela.
Tell me what you have that I don't.
Nothing. He'll get tired of me.
Master sleeps in your bed.
How do you know that?
I saw you. I watched you. I know you love him. I do too.
This is what the ego seeks, and to become aware of this darkness is necessary in order to understand the false self versus your true self. This kind of submission and obedience is what the ego wants, not the heart. And true intimacy is to reveal the fear behind this kind of behavior,
Anna,
so it can be understood.
Go to Escal away from me there. For once. Just do what you're told.
This behavior of the ego mind is also known as this, due to the disconnection of the heart.
If something were to happen to you because of me.
It won't. Nothing's gonna happen to me.
When the mind feels the love and the coherence of the heart, true intimacy can be shared. When you are able to see the lack of the mind, it is finally seen for what it is and understood by the heart. Elena also represents past versions of the ego that sometimes haunts you and tries to bring you back when you find true love.
Elena, I wanted to meet you.
I can't say the same. Excuse me.
Hey, I'm not the enemy.
I know what you did to Christian.
All I did was lead him to the truth of who he really is. Without me, he'd be in jail. Or dead. And he would say the same.
I'm not listening to that.
Do you think you're the first woman he'd hoped would save him? He needs a submissive in life. Not just in the bedroom.
No, he's changing that. It's not what he wants anymore.
But it's what he needs. And you don't strike me as the type of woman who wants to be owned.
To accept yourself fully, ego and all, is when you discover the real union and coherence of the mind and heart, which this scene symbolizes.
Are these burns? Who did this to you?
Go on, it's over.
I know how difficult it is for you to open up to me and tell me these things. But it means the world to me. It means you love me.
Yes, I do.
As the second film unfolds, Anastasia begins to see that Christian's obsession with dominance and control is rooted in fear.
Do you remember your birth, Mom?
I try not to.
What happened to her?
She overdosed. They found her body 3 days later.
Where were you?
I was with her.
Oh my God.
Took her away, took me to the hospital. Grace was there.
Thank you for telling me.
His struggles with jealousy and possessiveness reveal the ego's vulnerability, exposing the fragility behind the desire for power. This phase of their relationship shows how unchecked lust and the need for control gradually poison the intimacy they try to build, creating rifts instead of unity.
But you scared me more. Seeing you like that with her. I'll never be able to give you that kind of submission and obedience.
Anna.
Don't crowd me. I need space.
No, please don't do this.
Christian.
Don't give up on me.
I just need to think a little bit.
Don't leave me.
What are you doing? Get up.
And despite Christian's desire for Anastasia, she recognizes that he doesn't truly understand love, only possession. This realization mirrors the journey many people face in relationships, where intensity often masks as a lack of genuine love and emotional depth. For Anastasia, standing her ground and demanding more than physical passion becomes a crucial step in breaking through the ego's illusions.
I don't even understand your need to dominate.
I'm not a dominant. The right term is a sadist. I get off on punishing women, women who look like you.
Like your mother.
Yes. And I know how fucked up that is. When you left, I swore that I would stop it if that's what it took to get you back. But I am done with it. You mean more to me than anything else.
I want to believe you. I do, but I can't.
Give me your hand. This is me. All of me.
Christian.
I'm all yours.
Her insistence on love over lust shows the power of confronting the ego's hollow promises, pushing Christian to start embracing vulnerability, and reveals the true identity of the ego.
You've always known your own mind. If that man is the love of your life,
you grab him with both hands.
Christian, this is amazing.
Be mine. Share my life with me.
Yes.
Marry me.
I'll marry you.
Come here. Now yours.
By the final film, the couple's journey takes a turning point as Christian learns to see Anastasia beyond his own desires and fears. The focus shifts from a lust-fueled connection to one rooted in mutual respect and understanding. This shift represents the end of the ego's control, allowing the heart to take the lead.
Why do you defy me?
Because I can. I should misbehave more often.
Maybe you should.
Christian's awakening to love symbolizes the liberation from the ego's limited understanding of connection.
Good morning, wife.
Good morning, husband.
Realizing that love is not about possession, but about acceptance and harmony. Anastasia also wears the color red, which symbolizes the heart of love, affection, and strong emotions. This scene symbolizes the fear the mind feels when there is change in a new reality.
And the other assistants, they'll tell the detectives he did the scene.
I'm pregnant. 6 or 7 weeks.
You forgot your shot?
I know it's not good timing.
I have plans for us. I wanted to give you the world. Do you really think that I'm ready to be a father?
No. I don't. And I'm not ready to be a mother either, but we'll just figure it out.
I'm not ready to figure it out.
Children in film and TV in life always symbolize the transition into a new reality. And when this fear comes up, you always end up running back to what's comfortable in the past, which is symbolized when Christian visits Elena again.
And then you came home and you said that I would choose this baby over you. And you know what? If I have to, I will. I will choose this baby over anybody because that is what decent parents do. It's what your mother should have done for you, and I am so sorry that she didn't, Christian. I am sorry. But you are not a kid anymore, Christian. You need to grow the fuck up.
This confrontation is how the mind abandons the heart when change happens and seeks comfort rather than sharing true vulnerability.
Elena and I just talked. I was too angry with you.
I'm angry with you, Christian. You left me. You left me when I needed you. You fucked up.
Yes, I fucked up, and I'm sorry. I'm standing here telling you I'm sorry. Okay, she doesn't mean anything to me. I don't need her. I need you.
Would have been good if you felt that way yesterday.
This emotional pain of loss and tears is how the mind expands itself from past versions.
I was so awful to her, Mom. The things I said, I want to take them all back.
Sweetheart, if there was no room in marriage for mistakes, none of them would last more than a week. Tell her you're sorry and mean it. And then give her a little time.
I thought she was leaving me.
Not this one. She's tenacious, especially about things that she loves. And she does love you, Christian. You know that, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
Good. Oh, sweetheart.
Love always transforms the mind with its unconditional love.
Yeah, I want to have this baby with you. I was just scared. I wanted your world to begin and end with me.
It does. Christian, it does. You're my whole life. Are you crying? I know you think you're gonna be a really shitty dad, but you're not. This baby's gonna love you unconditionally, just like you loved your mother. You just have to forgive her.
This beautiful scene where Christian visits his mother's grave and forgives her is symbolizing the acceptance and forgiveness of unconscious behavior, the healing of the mind to unconditional love, and the ascension of consciousness.
You're the light, you're the night, you're the color of my blood. You're the cure, you're the pain, you're the only thing I wanna touch. Never knew that it...
Once the heart and mind are complete and whole, then lust transforms the pain into pure pleasure. Anastasia's journey reflects the esoteric truth that peace and fulfillment come from facing and confronting the ego's lack of love. By demanding love instead of control and choosing intimacy over mere physical connection, she embodies the heart's resilience. Her journey reveals that true love emerges when we confront the ego's illusions, choosing emotional depth connection over fleeting passion. In the end, 50 Shades of Grey illustrates a timeless esoteric truth. Love is the force that dissolves lust, control, and ego. Through Anastasia's courage to confront Christian's limitations, she not only finds peace, but also transforms Christian, showing that true love transcends the ego's cravings. For women, her journey is an empowering reminder that peace and fulfillment come from recognizing the difference between love and lust, choosing the path of the heart over the fleeting allure of the ego's illusions. And the truth is, when you have sex without love, it is poison for the body. So you must understand, when you have sex from the ego, it is just lust and poison. But when you have this unconditional love with a partner, this intimacy, then it becomes the most powerful way to experience love with another. And this trilogy symbolizes the transition from ego desires and lust to the unconditional love of the heart. In the end, 50 Shades of Grey reveals that love, not lust or control, brings liberation and wholeness. Please follow, like, save, and share for more free content to empower your life and to remember who you truly are.
So you want to play?
Yes, sir.
I'm Billy Rood, a reality consultant, manifestation coach.
You're tapping from the bottom, Mrs. Gray.
And I help people understand the purpose of this reality.
But I can live with that.
And remember who you really are with esoteric knowledge and symbolism.
What are you waiting for?
Check out my platform, 58 Magazine, for tons of free content to learn more about the unseen aspects of the human psyche and why you are here.
Kiss, okay? Because I'll never kiss. Come here.